Good evening to our senior class of 2020, and welcome to our DuBourg parents and families. We hope that soon we can gather together to celebrate graduation at the new cathedral, but this evening the ceremony takes place in our main lobby. This year we are celebrating 70 years of quality Catholic education at Bishop DuBourg, and it's interesting to note that the first class of 1954 graduated in this very same lobby. Interestingly enough, our seniors in the DBC Live class did a video this year interviewing members of that 1954 class. So through the 70 years of a Catholic education at Bishop DuBourg High School, the family connections from the first graduating class to our class graduating this evening have stayed strong. I want to commend our students and families, our faculty and staff, for their efforts during this difficult time. We continued to pray and learn online these past months. However, it was the lack of connecting with each other that made us feel isolated and alone. Not seeing each other in the halls, at lunch, and after school activities was missing in our lives. So I hope that in the future, when we can get together again, we have a better understanding and appreciation of what we mean to each other as the DuBourg family. While I am often teased about being a teacher for so many years here at DuBourg, I want to make sure that you understand I was not here in the lobby as a teacher for that 1954 graduation. But I am here tonight to honor and celebrate our seniors of the class of 2020. We're here to recognize their achievements in academics, the arts, and athletics. So as we always do at Bishop DuBourg, we begin with prayer. So Father Craig, please.
Friends, we are mindful of God's presence among us and within us, and we ask Him to bless this time of prayer and celebration. And we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray. You are the source and origin of all good things, Father. You are the source of all blessing and of all life. We give you thanks for the blessings you've bestowed upon the Bishop DuBourg community during the 2019-2020 school year, even under these challenging circumstances. Hear the prayers we make tonight for the class of 2020, their teachers, their parents, their family, and their friends. As we recognize their achievements this past year, may we also be mindful that their journey is only beginning, and that with every step they take, you promise to walk with them. We make this prayer with gratitude, through Christ who is our Lord forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and there is a time for every event under heaven. A time to give birth and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to throw stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to shun embracing. A time to search and a time to give up is lost. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear apart and a time to sew together. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace.
What profit is there to the worker from that in which he toils? I have seen the task that God has given the sons of men with which to occupy themselves. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in their heart, yet so that man will not find out the work that God has done from the beginning even to the end. I know that there is nothing better for them than to rejoice and to do good in one's lifetime. Moreover, that every man who eats and drinks sees good in all his labor. It is the gift of God. I know that everything God does will remain forever. There is nothing to add to it, and there is nothing to take from it. For For God has so worked that men should be in awe before him. The word of the Lord.
This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. But later, as the 11 were at table, Jesus appeared to them and rebuked them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they had not believed those who saw him after he had been raised. Jesus then said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim to every creature the gospel. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. So then the Lord Jesus, after he had spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. My friends, the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, friends, a word of congratulations to you on your academic achievements this past year here at Bishop DuBourg. A word of gratitude to your parents for partnering with our teachers and staff here at DuBourg to provide education to your children these last 4 years. It is a singular honor to partner with you and to cooperate with God's grace, who is always working in us and through us, and to help to create for you students an opportunity not only to grow and achieve academically, and not only to grow and achieve in the secular world, but also to grow and achieve as disciples of Jesus Christ. At some point, your parents or your grandparents or your guardians chose to send you to Bishop DuBourg Catholic High School. And when that happened, you and the Bishop DuBourg community committed to forming you not only intellectually and as citizens of the human family, but we also committed to a partnership to help form you into disciples of Jesus Christ. And today, at your virtual graduation, we celebrate that broad spectrum. We celebrate and give thanks to God for your academic and extracurricular achievements. We gather together to celebrate and give thanks to God for the growth that you've experienced as a person, and as a member of the human family, and as a citizen of our community. And we also gather here especially to give thanks to God, to glorify Him, that we have partnered together with His grace to form you into disciples of Jesus Christ. Now, your academic and extracurricular career here at Bishop DuBourg is coming to a close. Some of you are going on to college, some of you are going directly into the workplace, and we commend you and wish you well. But the one part of your journey that is only just beginning, or really is just continuing, is your mission to be disciples of Jesus Christ. That is only beginning, and it is continuing. And today, Jesus wants to step more deeply into our lives and into our hearts and commission us as he commissioned these disciples in the upper room. And so he says, go forth to you. Preach the good news. Accomplish good things. Do good things for others. And Jesus promises to walk with you. And so wherever you go, whether you're going on to college or university, whether you're going directly into the workplace or doing something else, know that your journey is only continuing. And Jesus will continue to empower and walk with you in wherever you go and whatever you do. Remember, friends, that no matter what we do or where we go, we are first and foremost disciples of Jesus Christ. He has touched your heart here at Bishop DuBourg. And through your academic work, through your extracurricular activities, through your classmates, a teacher, a friend, an encounter with him on your Kairos retreat or at our liturgies or our prayer together, Jesus has touched your heart. And he has walked with you these past 4 years. He only wants to continue walking with you. And it is our prayer for you today that we always have the gratitude and the humility to want to walk with him too. So friends, as your chaplain and as a priest and a pastor, I wish you the very best. I wish you all the happiness and all the health and safety and holiness that God has planned for you. Always know that he is walking with you every step of the way, and he will accomplish good things through you and for you and in you. Go forth, friends, and preach the good news. Amen.
For the church, Pope Francis and Robert our Bishop and Father Craig Holloway, that they may be blessed in all their endeavors as they follow the example of Christ the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those in our Bishop DuBourg faith community, that as brothers and sisters in Christ, we may be united to one another now more than ever in faith, hope, and love. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for the faculty, staff, coaches, and mentors at Bishop DuBourg who have guided our journey from our first steps into the building to our last steps as graduates. May they be blessed with happiness and peace all their days. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For Dr. Timney, in thanksgiving for the years of care and concern she has shown all of us, and that she will be blessed beyond measures as her new journey unfolds. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Ms. Mary Beth O'Donohue, Ms. Erin Luth, Mr. Ryan Newcomer, Ms. Karen Murphy, and Ms. Beth Mullen, that God blesses them abundantly as they pursue new pathways in life. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For us, the Bishop DuBourg Class of 2020, that God will walk next to us each day, blessing us with health, prosperity, and perseverance as we follow our dreams. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the souls of all who have died, especially Mrs. Lauren Moran, Bert Harbridge, and for all those who mourn, that the light of Christ's everlasting love will shine upon them in comfort and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
The Distinguished Alumnus Award, presented annually at Commencement, recognizes the personal, professional, and civic accomplishments of a DuBourg alumnus who has demonstrated a commitment to faith, family, and service. It is the highest honor that Bishop DuBourg High School can bestow on an alumnus. This year, our administration has chosen Mr. Tom Hunt as our Distinguished Alumnus. Tom graduated from Bishop DuBourg High School in 1973, graduated from St. Louis University in 1977 with a double major in biology and chemistry. He graduated from the St. Louis College of Pharmacy in 1980 and received his MBA from SLU in 1986. He has been the owner of Lindenwood Drugs since 1990. He is a compounding pharmacist for the St. Louis Zoo and is active in many pharmacy professional organizations. Tom is an active member of Our Lady of Sorrows Parish, a leader in the Boy Scouts, and a merit badge counselor. He most recently traveled to Qatar and India and even climbed Mount Kilimanjaro. He has been married to his wife Toni since 1979. They have two children, Ted, an 04 alum, and Ellen. Their two grandchildren are Clara and Watson. Tom has been a valued member of the Bishop DuBourg Advisory Board for years. He has often spoken to our juniors during Career Day presentations. Most recently, you may have recognized him as Santa Claus at our gala auction in November. I present to you Mr. Tom Hunt, our Distinguished Alumnus for 2020.
I am both honored and humbled at being named Bishop DuBourg's Distinguished Alum for this year. I would like to thank the administration, Mr. Reagan, Dr. Timoney, faculty and staff, and anyone else that may have had a part in this. I do not want to take much time, since this day is not about me, but about the great 2020 Bishop DuBourg graduating class. I would like to make a few points if I could. In 1973, just before my graduation from here, we had a flood along River De Pere, and we were excused from class for a few days to sandbag to help save some homes that were in danger of being filled with sewer water. Fast forward, and your class had to top every other disaster with a worldwide pandemic. I am sure you remember this, but probably not fondly. There are many things that you were looking forward to that did not happen, and I, along with many others, are sorry for your loss. I would like to ask you to remember one thing from your time here that will help you for the rest of your life. Faith in Christ, service to others. As long as you keep your faith alive, no matter what gets thrown at you, be it plague, flood, pandemic, you'll be able to survive and succeed. The service to others should not be taken lightly. The central core of my being is service to others. Almost every time I am asked to do something by someone, I do my best to help. Career Day Speaker, DuBourg Advisory Council, support for the school financially when asked and not asked. I am a huge believer in supporting students. I have a clinical teaching position with 5 or more colleges or universities that have professional pharmacy degree programs. You, the students, are our future, and it's very bright from where I am. I own and operate a small neighborhood pharmacy, and we have survived the last 30 years by giving service to our community and customers. I'm frequently asked when I will retire, but my response is that I love what I do, keeping people and their pets healthy, and sharing with students in the community. Why would I change, even during the current turmoil? My advice, keep your faith in Christ and serve everyone you can. The rest will be easy. Congratulations.
Friends, united by bonds of faith, hope, and love, let's pray together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We close with prayer. Dear God, we give you thanks and praise for this group of students, these graduates of the class of 2020. Send a new outpouring of your Spirit to empower them to accomplish good works in your name. Make them always instruments of peace and justice, especially for those in most need. And may we, as their community, continue to support them with prayer and love as they walk as disciples of Jesus Christ. And to the graduates of the class of 2020, may God, who has begun his good work in you, bring it to completion. And may he bless you today and every day, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Just where we We would like to ask Ben Katzenbaum to come forward and share his reflection on behalf of the class of 2020.
Blood alone moves the wheels of history. It is incumbent that we remember that, especially in times of great loss and of great bloodshed. We have recently found ourselves living under circumstances that not only test our individual wills, but the combined will of all of those who are tormented by this common enemy. This enemy has stripped away many of the things we deem important for the vitality of our lives. Our enemy has taken away the classes we were supposed to take, the sports we were supposed to play, the friendships we were supposed to cherish, the prom we were supposed to dress up for, the theater production we were supposed to act in, the faculty and staff we were supposed to laugh with, the detentions we were supposed to serve, the school lunches we were supposed to eat, the fun we were supposed to have, the tears we were supposed to shed, the smiles we were supposed to share, the aisle we were supposed to walk down, the diploma we were supposed to hold, the applause we were supposed to hear, the hugs we were supposed to give, the love we were supposed to feel, the precious memories we were supposed to make, and a year we were supposed to never forget. And just like that, as if we were never there in the first place, snatched right out of our hands, it was gone. So unexpected, so out of nowhere. How could we have possibly prepared for such an atrocity, for such a rapid change in our way of life? For our future plans to be crumbled into irreparable pieces before our very eyes? And the answer is we couldn't have. We couldn't have prepared for what was to come. We couldn't have known that March 16th would be the last time we stepped inside of Bishop DuBourg High School as students. Have you ever asked yourselves in an hour of meditation, which everyone finds during the day, how long we have been striving for greatness? These last 4 years of our lives have been in preparation for our lives to come. So although we have lost so much and left so many behind, there is still so much more to look forward to. Each one of you will leave your mark on this world in your own special and unique way. In the past week, I've spent some time looking at the Instagram page that DuBourg has dedicated to the class of 2020. And in doing so, I'm given the smallest glimpses of your aspirations, whether that be the university you plan to attend, the major you plan to study, perhaps the profession you plan to pursue. And looking, I'm given a glimpse of the legacy you will leave behind. It is vital that we remember this, and not only for the years we've been at war, the war against COVID-19, but from the moment, as a child, when we realized that the world could be conquered. It has been a lifetime struggle and a never-ending fight. And although the loss of this senior year is not comparable to that of a loved one or family member, it is a loss nonetheless. Bishop DuBourg, class of 2020, I say to you, and you will understand, that it is a privilege to fight. I ask you once more, rise, rise and be worthy of this historical hour. No revolution is worth anything if it cannot defend itself. Today, we will not allow a virus to take away our happiness, our achievements, our lives. This is our duty, to be lights amidst darkness, to spread happiness in fields of hate and gloom, and to spread hope in this time of hopelessness, to take control of our history. And so, I say to you, Bishop DuBourg, class of 2020, we must never acquiesce, for it is together that we prevail. Not as students, not as the class of 2020, but as graduates of Bishop DuBourg High School. Thank you.
Before we honor each of the students of the class of 2020, we would like to acknowledge the students who have received our top awards. We want each of these students to be recognized by our entire Bishop DuBourg community. The Archbishop May Service Award is presented annually to one senior from each of the Catholic high schools in the Archdiocese. Named to honor the late Archbishop May and his dedication to Christian service and social justice, the Archbishop May Award recognizes students dedicated to serving others. Christian service is an integral part of our Catholic faith, and service hours are a normal requirement at local high schools. But the Archbishop May Award recipients have gone far and above the requirements, making service a focus of their daily lives. This senior truly lives our motto, faith in Christ, service to others. Our Archbishop May's Service Award recipient this year is Emma Ingram. The top award that we present each year is the Bishop DuBourg Award. This award recognizes the senior who demonstrates the qualities of our school's namesake, Bishop Louis William Valentine DuBourg. These qualities include enthusiasm, optimism, leadership, service, and academic excellence. It is great honor that we present this year's Bishop DuBourg Award to Akayla Henson and Elliot Johnson. And now we would like to recognize the class of 2020 for their many accomplishments and acknowledge their future plans.
Abigail Renee Adams will be attending St. Louis Community College. She plans on studying biochemistry and pre-med. Christina M. Adams has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, summa cum laude honors. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Dean Scholarship and the DePaul Award. She will be attending DePaul University and study psychology. Jacqueline Alvarez has received the Campus Ministry Department Award. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College. Richard J. Bakersmith has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Magna Cum Laude Honors. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Dean's Scholarship, and he will be attending Columbia College in Chicago, where he will study game design or animation. Emmanuel Bessereau has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Maryville University and study business administration. Samuel A. Beckerly has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Rankin Technical College or St. Louis Community College, where he will study computer science. Elena Bainan. She has received the Legacy Award. She will be attending Missouri State University. Nicholas G. Blessing has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the Legacy Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Dr. T.A. Starzinski Scholarship. He will be attending the University of Missouri, Columbia, and study social work. Sky Boyster plans on joining the workforce. Patrick J. Bronca has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, summa cum laude honors. He has received the Science Department Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Bright Flight Scholarship and the Presidential Scholarship. He will be attending St. Louis College of Pharmacy and study pharmaceutical science. Anastasia Brown has received the Ray Baines 3-Star Athlete Award. She has earned the Arizona Recognition Award, and she will be attending University of Arizona. Hannah M. Cordell has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the Art Department Award. She was a member of the French National Honor Society and a member of the Art National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study graphic design. Mara R. Kern will be attending Missouri State University. Alexis C. Davis has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, and she is a member of the National Art Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Scholarship Program. She will be attending Rankin Technical College and study cybersecurity and computer hardware. Shelby K. Denning has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Magna Cum Laude Honors, and was a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study animal science and theater. Isabel G. Dimas has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Graber School of Hair Design and study cosmetology. Jason Dunn will be attending St. Louis Community College. Jared S. Ebert has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the National Choral Award, and is a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending St. Louis Community College and study theater. John Wayne Thomas Eichhorst, has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the Legacy Award. He has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending St. Louis Community College and plans on studying marketing. Rena Marie Ellery will be attending Murray State University and study veterinary science. Luke M. Enright has received the Physical Education Department Award, the Kevin Regan Elite Cavalier Award, the Ray Bain Three-Star Athlete Award, and the Legacy Award. He has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He plans on wrestling at Central Methodist University. Madison P. Fisher has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the Legacy Award. She has also earned summa cum laude honors, and she was a member of our National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study nursing. Isaac James Fulton has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and summa cum laude honors. He will be attending Murray State University and study business administration. Madison N. Galzinski has received the Murray Cup Award, the Ray Bain Three-Star Athlete Award, and the Legacy Award. She has earned the Access Missouri Grant, Catholic High School Award, Fontbonne College Scholarship, and the Fontbonne Grant. She will be playing softball at Fontbonne University. Maria B. Girth has received the Pro-Life Club Award and the Ray Baines Three-Star Athlete Award. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Southeast Missouri State University and study psychology. Emily K. Grither has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, summa cum laude honors, Science Department Award, Spanish Department Award. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship, the Bell Tower Award, Breen Scholarship, Loyola Scholarship, and the Regent Scholarship. She will be attending Rockhurst University and study physical therapy. Caroline Patricia Guffey has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the Theater Department Award, the DBC Live Leadership Award, and the Liturgical Music Award. She was a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Columbia College Scholars Award and the Dean Scholarship. She will be attending Columbia College in Chicago and plans on studying photography and performing arts management. Edward M. Gunn has received the Theater Department Award. He'll be attending Fontbonne University. Olivia T. Harbridge has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. She will be attending DePaul University and study cybersecurity. Christiana A. Hayes will be attending Alverno College in Wisconsin and studying nursing. Stephen P. Hegney has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Jefferson College and study psychology. Edward Quinton Henneberry has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, cum laude honors, and was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies. He has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship and will be attending Missouri University of Science and Technology and study engineering. Elizabeth A. Henning has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, cum laude honors, and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the National Honor Society and a member of the National French Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Rockhurst University and study child psychology. Akayla A. Henson has received the Bishop DeBerg Award, the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, summa cum laude honors, the Ray Baines Three-Star Athlete Award, and also the English Department Award. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and the president of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship, the Carr Scholarship, Gold Level Diversity Scholarship, Racers Give Award. She will be attending Murray State University and plans on studying political science and pre-law. Emma E. Ingram has received the Archbishop May Service Award, the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, summa cum laude honors, the Social Studies Department Award, and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and the National Honor Society. She has earned the Barra Scholarship, the Dean's Award, and the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Maryville University and study communication sciences and disorders. Elliot A. Johnson has received the Bishop DuBourg Award and the Ray Baines Three Star Athlete Award. He has earned the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Missouri State University and study business administration. Haley N. Johnson was a member of the National Art Honor Society. She plans on joining the workforce and becoming a tattoo artist. Benjamin L. Katzefam has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors, the Spanish Department Award, the Math Department Award, and the English Department's Writing Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Bright Flight Scholarship, the Jesuit Community Scholarship, the Presidential Scholarship, Campus Housing Award, and the Catholic High School Award. He will be attending St. Louis University and study physical therapy. Ryan M. Lampe has received the Legacy Award, and he was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies. He has earned the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Webster University and study computer science. Ni T. Lee has received the Technology Department Award, and she was a member of the National Art Honor Society. She plans on joining the workforce as an artist or programmer. Anna R. Lemley plans on attending Fontbonne University and study psychology. Mason T. Levitt has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors, the Math Department Award, and the Legacy Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies, a member of the National Art Honor Society, and a member of the National Art Honor Society. He has earned the Groundbreaker Package Scholarship and the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Missouri University of Science and Technology and study mathematics. Stephen J. Loretta plans on playing soccer at Fontbonne University, where he will study business administration. Stephen E. Ludwig has received the Legacy Award. He's earned the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Mineral Area College and study automotive technology. Rachel E. McCloskey has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the Ray Baines Three Star Athlete Award, and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Copper Dome Scholarship, the Residence Life Leadership Award, and the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Southeast Missouri State University. Matthew Boyce McGraw has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, and he was a member of the National Honor Society. He will be attending Creighton University and study pharmacy. Patrick D. Meehan was a National Merit Finalist. He has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and the National Honor Society. He has earned the Bright Flight Scholarship, the Benequisto Scholarship, the Green and Gold Scholarship, and the Tradition of Excellence Scholarship. He will be attending University of South Florida and study mathematics. Alexandria N. Menendez has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the Religion Department Award, the French Department Award, and the Counseling Department Award. She was a member of the National Honor Society and a member of the French National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship, the Access Missouri Grant, Copper Dome Scholarship, Residence Life Leadership Award, Academic Spirit Center Award, and the Academic Spirit Center Textbook Award. She will be attending Southeast Missouri State University and studying nursing. Alicia M. Merlenbach will be attending St. Louis Community College and then William Woods University. She plans on majoring in equine studies or become an EMT. Jabari S. Merriweather will be attending Eureka College. Adam J. Meyer has earned the Missouri A Plus Schools Program Scholarship, and he will be attending St. Louis Community College. Jack L. McNicko has received the Legacy Award. He will be attending the St. Louis Carpenters Joint Apprenticeship Program, where he will study carpentry and construction management. Elijah A. Miller will be attending St. Louis Community College and study audio engineering. Fatima Miranda Pena has received the Campus Ministry Department Award. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study nursing. Ariana R. Miller has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Missouri State University, where she plans on studying business administration with an emphasis in management. Grace K. Newcomb is undecided at this time on where she wants to go and what she might want to study. Addison I. Neethy has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors, and the French Department Award. She also received the St. Louis Post-Dispatch Scholar Athlete Award, the Ray Baines 3-Star Athlete Award, and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies, a member of the National Honor Society, and a member of the French National Honor Society. She has earned the Presidential Scholarship. She plans on playing soccer at Harris Stowe University, where she plans on studying occupational therapy. Thomas C. Oliver has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending St. Louis Community College. Kewan C. Owens will be attending Webster University, where he will study biochemistry. Jacob Alex Raymond will be attending St. Louis Community College. Isabella M. Reed has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College, where she plans on studying social work, public health, where she will become a substance abuse counselor. Dominic A. Ruggieri has received the Legacy Award. He has earned the Copper Dome Scholarship and the Residence Life Leadership Award. He will be attending Southeast Missouri State University, where he plans on studying cybersecurity and computer science. Jared P. Shankman will be attending Maryville University, where he plans on studying sports management. Ben J. Stallis has received the Legacy Award. He will be attending St. Louis Community College. Matthew Lawrence Sullivan has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, the Summa Cum Laude Honors, and the Legacy Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He plans on playing soccer at St. Louis Community College. Emily Marie Sweeney has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and Cum Laude Honors. She's earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending University of Missouri Columbia, where she plans on studying business administration with an emphasis in marketing. Jacob G. Tatko has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors, the Louis Armstrong Award. He was a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies and a member of the National Honor Society. He has earned the Barra Scholarship and the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Maryville University, where he will study physical therapy. Alexander C. Veneman has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence, Summa Cum Laude Honors, who's a member of the Academy of Advanced Studies, a member of the National Honor Society, and a member of the National Art Honor Society. He has earned the SLU Higher Purpose Scholarship and the SLU Campus Housing Award. He will be attending St. Louis University, where he will study marketing and communications. Humberto Viveros plans on joining the workforce in the areas of arts and entertainment. Claire L. Vollett was a member of the National Honor Society and is earning the Legacy Award. She will be attending Rockhurst University. Catherine F. Vollett has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the DBC Live Leadership Award, also the Legacy Award. She was a member of the National Honor Society. She will be attending Rockhurst University. Benjamin Thomas Walsh has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending St. Louis Community College and study graphic communications. Caitlin E. Watson has received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence and the Legacy Award. She has earned Summa Cum Laude Honors and was a member of the National Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study elementary education. Tyree N. Wesley has received the Martin Luther King Model of Justice Award. He has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. He plans on playing volleyball at Georgetown College or Missouri Baptist University, where he will study social and criminal justice. Jasmine M. White Ford has earned the Missouri A+ Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study occupational therapy. Caitlin B. Wilk has received the English Department's Reading Award and the Legacy Award. She was a member of the National Art Honor Society. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending St. Louis Community College and study English. Sarah K. Williams has received the Family and Consumer Science Department Award. She has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. She will be attending Southeast Missouri State University and study physiology. Royal William Wobey has received the Legacy Award. He has earned the Missouri A-Plus Schools Program Scholarship. He will be attending Webster University and study film production. That is the Bishop DuBourg class of 2020. And no matter where you are right now, I think this class deserves a standing ovation and a huge round of applause. Let's hear it for him.
We would like to ask Akayla Henson to come forward and share her reflection on the behalf of the class of 2020.
So I guess by now, all of us have realized that high school is nothing like Clueless, Napoleon Dynamite, or even High School Musical. We have had some movie moments here and there, but our ending is a little different. A graduation is special because it is a reflection on what we have accomplished and who we have become. It is a time to stop and truly appreciate how far we have come together. This means that we have survived and passed all 4 years of high school. Those sleepless nights and random breakdowns are all becoming worth it. This means that we have beat the odds when many people did not think we would make it this far, and we proved them wrong. Graduation has been the milestone that many of us have been waiting to reach, but the little yet significant moments before this will become the most special for us. They will be the ones we remember most. Here at DuBourg, I've met so many different people, ones I will never forget. We may be leaving this school behind, but the memories we have of each other here will forever be in our hearts. Bishop DuBourg has given us lifelong friends, ones we will call when we want to celebrate, when life gets tough, or even when we just want to talk. I just want to thank each and every one of you for going on this journey with me, this non-High School Musical journey. Some of you have been here all 4 years and others less. The time doesn't matter. It's the distance that we've covered together as a family, the Cavalier family. We have gone the distance and here we stand at the end. Yet this end is the start of something new for all of us. Charlie Munger once said, "You're not going to get very far in life based on what you already know. You're going to advance in life by what you're going to learn after you leave here." I believe that doesn't only apply to the things that will come from a book or even a professor. This applies to every aspect of our lives. We will learn things about others and the world around us that will take us to the next level. What happens next is going to be scary. What happens next is going to be fun. What happens next is going to be life-changing. But most importantly, what happens next is going to be amazing for each of us individually. We may not see it when it happens, but I know that down the line, we will know that this next step in our lives will have shaped us into who and what we needed to be. I love you, class of 2020.
By the power given to me by Archbishop Carlson of the Archdiocese of St. Louis, I proclaim the aforesaid students to as graduates of Bishop DuBourg High School of the class of 2020, and with all its rights, privileges, and responsibilities. Congratulations. Elliot, please come and do the honors.
To the class of 2020, we've been through the good times, we've been through the bad times, but after all the long hours and hard work we've put in, we did it. Please join me in switching our tassels. Congratulations.